Good morning and welcome. My name is Derek Hinchliffe. I'm a licensed practitioner here at CSL Kelowna, and I also have the honor of serving on the Board of Trustees as your treasurer. Now, you don't need me to tell you that there's very little that is regular about our world today, and that includes our little world here at CSL Kelowna. What is normally the Sunday 6 is today the Sunday 2. Our musical directors, Barb Samuel and Neil Klassen, are still enjoying some much-deserved rest and relaxation in Mexico, while our doctors, Ken and Deborah Gordon, are in California for the annual convention of Centers for Spiritual Living. But don't worry, we'll still be bringing you some uplifting music and a thought-provoking message about embracing the now. As Amanda Pope will share with you, awareness and appreciation of wonder can only happen in the now. In fact, everything happens in the now. There is no other moment. By being present in wonder, we are transformed by coming into alignment with life. But first, we'll start with some music, and trust me when I tell you that this is uplifting music. I don't know about you, but in the middle of winter, I could really use an infusion of energy, of bright color, and of fun. And just like Cinderella's fairy godmother, Tanya Lipscomb is fulfilling my wish. She has energy, she has bright colors, she even has little wings, and yes, she is full of fun.
Hello, Kelowna Center for Spiritual Living. This is Tanya Lipscomb. I am so happy to be in your living room celebrating this beautiful day and singing for you. Nothing lasts forever. Nothing stays the same. Oh, this moment is a treasure. And it'll never come again. So when you're looking for freedom, honey, dance like a child in the rain. 'Cause nothing lasts forever. No joy, no pain. When you're down on your luck, yeah, you're down and out. Like you're stuck in a rut, just going round and round. Well, don't forget about change. She'll dance across your floor, help you rearrange what you're searching for. Might set you straight. Ooh, she might lead you astray. But she's always coming on hot. Oh, whether you're ready or not. She might bring on a hurricane of hardship and strife. But you know what? She can also bring on the very best days of your life. Oh, 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 oh. Nothing lasts forever. Nothing stays the same. But this moment, it's a treasure. Ooh, it'll never come again. So when you're looking for freedom, honey, dance like a child in the rain. Because nothing lasts forever. Ooh, no joy, no pain. Oh, ooh, 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 when you find it hard to see the light. Oh, and nothing's going right. When the weight is too hard to bear. I know we've all been there. Oh, you're not alone. In your darkest times, this will all pass and you'll find the light. Because nothing lasts forever. Ooh, nothing stays the same. And this moment is a treasure, and it'll never, never come again. So when you're looking for freedom, honey, dance like a child in the rain, 'cause nothing lasts forever. No joy, no pain. Nothing lasts forever. Excuse me. No joy.
Thank you, Tanya. See, I told you she was full of energy and fun. I'm so happy to be here this morning, and I'm so happy that you are here this morning. Our purpose here at CSL Kelowna is to awaken humanity to its spiritual magnificence. Did you notice I said awaken? We believe that everything required for living a full and happy life is already within us. We just need to be reminded of who and whose we truly are. We provide spiritual tools for personal and global transformation, and together we are creating a world that works for all. Right now I'd like to share with you something that was written by Dr. Petra Weldes, the co-spiritual director of CSL Dallas. And if you're willing, I'd like to ask you to just close your eyes. She says, awakening to who you truly are can be a process. Remembering that you are light may come and go. The seduction of the facts of physical reality can be persuasive. The patterns of thinking, believing, seeing can be habitual. Sometimes it feels like you awaken only to fall back asleep again, or become conscious only to go unconscious again. But do not be discouraged. Every bit of awareness is adding to your awakening. Every bit of illumination shifts your consciousness just a little bit more. Every moment you are awake to the presence of the spiritual reality adds to you remembering who you truly are. The good news is you cannot unlearn what you know or forget what you have realized. Trust the process. Every moment you are a little more yourself and a little more awake. Every moment you are a little closer to living in a state of enlightenment, being the light that you already are. Once again, that was written by Petra Weldes from CSL Dallas in Texas. So I have a few quick announcements. Next Sunday, we have a community chat. Remember when we were able to still meet in person and afterwards we would have fellowship, coffee, cookies? Well, this is the COVID version of that, where we do it safely over Zoom. So that's next Sunday, immediately following the service. And another opportunity for fellowship is what we call coffee and connections. It's every second Thursday at 10, which means the next one will be Thursday, January 27th. And again, that's over Zoom. And then 2 weeks from today is our next Board of Trustees meeting. All of the details for all of this can be found on our website, cslkelowna.org. And now we will move into our time of spiritual practice. We're fortunate to have a recording of Barb Neal singing in this very room. And following that, I'm going to share with you a meditation that was written by our founder, Dr. Ernest Holmes. You can find it at the back of this book, Living the Science of Mind. Right now, here's Barb and Neal with In This Very Room.
In this very room, there's quite enough love for all the world. And in this very room, there's quite enough joy for all the world. And there's quite enough peace and quite enough power to walk through our every fear. For spirit, one spirit is in this very room. And in this unity, we do live in harmony, and peace has come as we are one. We are one. We are one. I am you. You are me. We are one. And in this unity, we are one, and peace has come as we are one. Ladies and gentlemen, our practitioner of the week.
Thank you, Barb. Thank you, Neil. Dr. Holmes writes, I know there is a power for good which is responding to me and bringing into my experience everything that is necessary to my unfoldment, to my happiness, to my peace, to my health, and to my success. I know there is a power for good that enables me to help others and to bless the whole world. So I say quietly to myself, there is one life. That life is God, that life is perfect, and that life is my life now. It is flowing through me, circulating in me. I am one with its rhythm. My heart beats with the pulsations of the universe, in serenity, in peace, and enjoy. My whole physical being is animated by the divine, and if there is anything in it that does not belong, it is cast out because there is one perfect life in me now. And I say to myself, I am daily guided so that I shall know what to do under every circumstance, in every situation. Divine intelligence guides me in love, in joy, and in complete self-expression. Desiring that the law of good alone shall control me, I bless and prosper everything I am doing. I multiply every activity. I accept and I expect happiness and complete success. Realizing that I am one with all people, I affirm that there is a silent power flowing through me, and which blesses and heals and prospers, makes happy and glad their pathway. And realizing that the world is made up of people like myself, I bless the world and affirm that it shall come under the divine government of good, under the divine providence of love, and under the divine leadership of the supreme intelligence. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. And so it is. And here once again is Tanya.
This is called the blessing. What a blessing to be here with you. What a blessing to be here now. All this love in one place, such beauty and grace. What a blessing to be here. Nothing like love to bring us together. Nothing like love to bring us to our knees. Whether it's a raging storm or a sweet, gentle breeze, love, it'll bring us home. And love and loss, they go hand in hand. A baby is born, then we lose a dear friend. Oh, while we're busy living and dying, let us not stop trying to do the very best that we can. 'Cause it's a blessing to be here with you. And it's a blessing to be here now. Oh, all this love in one place, such beauty and grace. What a blessing to be here with you. There are times in our life we'll try and try and we'll fail. Other times we're gonna be the top of the pile. And if we're there for one another and we're kind and help each other, that's the power and glory of this divine connection, union of souls. And we stand on sacred ground, giving thanks all around for the sweet memories we can taste in the air. Oh, we can taste them, 'cause it's a blessing to be here with you. And it's a blessing to be here now. All this love in one place, such beauty and grace. What a blessing to be here with you.
Thank you so much, Tanya. It is a blessing to be here with you. And it's a blessing to be here now. And what a great song to set the tone for this message, where we're going to talk all about embracing the now today. And Derek really set us up with his beautiful meditation from Ernest Holmes and the reading from Dr. Peter Valdez, and really setting that space for the power of the present moment. So last week we talked about wonder, and we talked about it being the antidote to, you know, in what the world right now in all its unusualness gets too much. Finding the wonder is that place that neutralizes, that brings us back into our joy and our peace. And that wonder we know can only be found in the present moment. So I'm excited to explore a little deeper today that really finding the present moment, being in the presence. And what we find in the present moment, that is where our peace is, that is where our joy is, that is where wonder is, that is the point of healing, and it is the point of power. And Eckhart Tolle, one of my favorite authors in his book, A New Earth, he said that it's actually the source of happiness. He said, there are three words that convey the secret of the art of living, the secret of all success and happiness: one with life. He says, being one with life is being one with now. So that's that idea of fully being present now to find our solid foundation, to find our happiness. And Ernest Holmes as well talks about that place of finding the stillness. He calls it the silence, going into that present moment, listening to that still small voice within. And he talks about that being the place of creative power in our lives. He says, here in our secret place of Most High, the inner chamber of our own soul, are written the sacred words, I am. It is from this consciousness, this I am, conceived in silent recognition, that power flows. Isn't that beautiful? That silent recognition that our creative power is really just between us and that still small voice within. So if we don't live in the present moment, then where do we live? Well, we live with our focus either looking backwards or looking forwards. And I mean, the reality is it's ridiculous. We can't be anywhere but right here and right now. And yet, how many of us really reside here? And I said to Derek on the way in, I said, if there is one person that needs to hear this talk today, it is me. And I know that, you know, with a lot going on, we can be pulled looking backwards, looking forwards. And we can be pulled out of the richness, of the beauty, of the wholeness, of the perfection of the present moment. So if we look backwards, we could be reminiscing, we can be ruminating. Have you ever done that? You go and have a conversation with somebody and then you spend hours ruminating over, oh, I wish I'd said that. Oh, I wish I hadn't said that. Oh, I'm just not sure. And did I do that right? Or was I did I make the right choice? We can be ruminating. Worse still, we can be regretting. We can be stuck in this place of living in the past, wishing it was different. We can actually even, on a positive note, we can be looking back with nostalgia, remembering the good old days. And you know, in this point of creation, in the present moment, sometimes even when our focus is on the past, in nostalgia, what we're actually creating and what we're really saying is, the good is behind me. That's kind of over now. And it can almost come from a place where I don't have that opportunity anymore. Maybe I'm too old, I'm too this. That was back then when I had more energy and I was carefree. So even looking back with positive can also pull us out of the beauty of this moment. Now, it certainly is great to be aware of our past, aware of our future, but we have to always come back to that present moment to really find the peace and that creative power. If we look forward, we can do so with anticipation, good or bad anticipation, like I'm so excited for this to come, or ooh, I hope this works out okay. Or we can be looking forward with worry. We can have that, you know, that analysis paralysis where you've got to make a decision and you've made up a story in your own mind that there is only one right answer. And if you don't find it, the world will end. And we can live in that place of that's that future looking, anxiety provoking kind of mentality. And again, what are we creating in this moment when that's our focus? We are creating this outside, almost putting our energy into that thing not working out. We're putting so much pressure on it as to it has to be a certain thing. And even when we're looking forward with excitement, you know, that can be great. I mean, it's great to vision and to visualize what we'd like to experience. But if we're excited about a future thing, we really have to be careful that it's not we're not creating this conditional happiness. I'll be happy when. I'm so glad that's happening. Thank God spring's gonna be here soon because I'm so sick and tired of the snow that's now all muddy and gross. You know, that takes us out of the beauty of the present moment, the presence. And you know, that healing can happen in the present moment. That's the only place it can happen. Even if there's, you know, things in our past or fears of our future, right now is where the healing moment is. Eckhart Tolle talks about awareness, and he says, awareness means presence, and only presence can dissolve the unconscious past in you. So again, it's this moment here. All of the good is right here and right now. So I have to admit that I am a bit of a ruminator. I have a big imagination, so I've spent a lifetime imagining the future, ruminating over the past, and it's really taken a lot of time for me to really train myself to be able to settle into the present moment. And depending on the day, I'm more successful than other times. But there is still a time where I struggle. Like if I'm gonna be honest, I suck at being present. And that's when it's related to my son. Now, I don't know what it is, if it's a biological thing or an evolutionary thing, but there's something about being a parent, I think, that just, there is this link that I can go to worry, I can go to fear, I can go to rumination so easily. So often when I'm preparing a talk, I have the opportunity to explore the topic myself, which I'm starting to think is a little frightening. Anyway, so I had the opportunity with my struggle with presence with my son. On Friday night, he and his girlfriend came over for a visit. We had dinner together. It was a lovely time. They stayed way past my bedtime because they live on a different schedule than I do. And they left, probably it was like 10:45 that night to drive home. So, you know, it's a winter night, and I always say or try to resist saying, you know, drive safely. So, of course, immediately I go up to bed because it's way past my bedtime, and I'm washing my face and brushing my teeth, whatever I'm doing, and I hear, within about 5 minutes, I hear my phone on my night table starting to buzz, that vibrating buzzing, and I just think, oh my goodness. Anybody who knows me and would feel comfortable calling me this late knows that I go to bed way earlier than this. My son just left. if this has got to be him calling. And immediately I launch into all, my mind gets just in darts off in all these directions. Why is he calling? Thankfully, he was okay. What had happened is, and if you live in Kelowna, you will know that right now, with all the snow and the weather we've had, there are small vehicle-sized potholes all over the road. And with all the melting, those have filled up with puddles. And at 11 o'clock at night, they're hard to see. So unfortunately, he had hit one of these giant potholes and blown out a tire. And he was on the side of the road and he said, you know, what should I do? So we talked about it and he was okay. And then, of course, I finish my bedtime routine. I get into bed and I lie there with my eyes this wide. I'm thinking about my son. I mean, he's safe. It's irrational, right? He's safe. He's with his girlfriend. He's called BCAA. Everything is okay. And yet I'm ruminating. Should I have gone to see him? Should I be helping him? Is there more? I mean, God knows I don't know anything about changing a tire, but there's this question of, is he okay? Should I check in with him? Is he warm enough? It's a cold evening out there. He's going to be stuck on the side of the road. And my mind, I really, in that moment, had to talk myself through. Amanda, he's a 24-year-old man. He is very capable. He has a cell phone that works clearly because he just called me. There is nothing I need to do in this moment. I'm not helpful to him at all because I can't change a tire. So I had to really talk myself through. And I had to find that presence despite all my mind wanting to go to those protective places, which is really a fallacy, right? It's not protecting anybody. My worry is not actually creating anything beneficial. So I was able to talk myself through, you know, lying there, I was able to close my eyes and I sort of drifted into my mind wandering and then drifted back into presence and breathing. And, you know, I could listen to Derek's breath beside me and just allow that to calm me down. And eventually I was able to find that peace. So it was a really good reminder for me about, you know, what to do in those moments where I get launched out of presence, into worry, into future, into backwards thinking, you know, outside of this present moment. And of course, in the end, everything was just fine. I talked to my son the next day, and in fact, he had some gifts in the experience. He actually started to change his own tire. And so he said, you know, if I can be accepted to law school, surely to goodness I can change a tire. So he started doing that and he and his girlfriend were figuring it out. And then a security guard pulled over and helped them. And he was reminded of the kindness of strangers. And then the BCAA person showed up and helped him. And it ended up being a really positive experience where he learned a lot. He was resilient and resourceful, and he got the help of strangers. There was nothing required by me. And isn't that the truth? Like so often, all of that being out of the present moment is really just a fabrication of nothing, of nothingness. So the other thing that we can find in the present moment, in that stillness, in the silence, is divine guidance. That still, small voice within that guides us, that has the answers to what we, whatever it is that we're struggling with. So Ernest Holmes said, "We are surrounded by a principle of mind and intelligence, which will become divine guidance to us, provided we permit it to do so." So provided we permit it to do so. And you know what we have to do? Is we have to get our bloated nothingness out of the way. We have to be in the present moments. We have to allow the divine, not the Amanda Pope worry machine. We have to settle in to that present moment. Now, divine guidance, I don't know about you, but it doesn't show up like I would like it to. What I would appreciate in divine guidance is I would appreciate it to come fully packaged. I love assembling furniture. You know when you get IKEA furniture and it comes and it's a whole bunch of pieces, But what you get is an instruction manual that shows you exactly how it's going to turn out in the end. And then it shows you exactly what you need to do. Step one, step two, step three. You get all the little pieces, all that tedious little work is done for you. The holes are drilled, the screws are all the right size. And all you have to do is look at the picture, know that that's how it's going to work out, and follow each step. That's what I would like in divine guidance. But sadly, that is not my experience. What my experience is with divine guidance is when I do get present, that there is a still small voice that speaks. And that still small voice speaks usually just about the next step. It just says, here's step one. And it is a resonant clarity within me that knows that this is my step one. And I don't get the luxury of seeing necessarily how it's going to turn out or what step two and what step three are going to be. What I get to do is I get to be present. I get to live in faith. That's the peace in that present moment is I have faith in that still small voice. I have faith in the divine guidance. I don't allow myself to just go out into that worry of the past and I made this mistake before and what is this going to turn out like? I stay clear. And what a beautiful place to be peace, at peace, to be clear, to let go of the having to figure it all out on my schedule, which is laughable as we know. So really, we need to be in the present moment. We need to find that way. And the good news is, it's not something that we have to go out and master and it's going to take 10 years. Holmes tells us that the silence is not some peculiar, strange place which we arrive at either by fasting or feasting. It is any moment in our experience, day or night, when the mind realizes its unity with good. So that's all we have to do. Realize our unity with good. It is within us. It is right here, right now, whether I can see the instruction manual and the end picture. It is in the present moment. And we can do this, I mean, fasting and feasting and all kinds of ritual, if that's your thing and that is what really moves you into that place of presence, that is absolutely fine. There is nothing wrong with that. But you know what else can move us there? Taking one intentional, conscious breath. What can move us there is getting lost in music. The beautiful sound of somebody else's art, looking at any kind of art, can bring us into the present moment. Just being mindful about the actions we're taking. You can become a guru through washing dishes or, you know, walking down the stairs or doing something mundane in your life. This is that chop wood and carry water. Like, we can find enlightenment in any moment, in only the present moment. And in that space is the wonder. In the space is that healing, is that wholeness, the power, the creative power where we get to create our experience from that place of wholeness, from that place of peace, with divine guidance. As Eckhart Tolle said, it's in that place that we find happiness. And to quote the very lovely Tanya Lipscomb, nothing lasts forever. This moment is a treasure. So I hope you'll join with me this week in finding that presence, in finding that present moment, in being aware, in finding the power in the presence, in taking that conscious breath, in reaching out to somebody so you can find that stillness together. In meditation, in mindfulness, in just finding and settling into the power of you, the power of the moment. So thank you for being here. Thank you for being on this journey with me. Thank you for being part of this community. I love you. I thank you. I bless you.
Amanda, thank you so much. That was a rich message, full of wonderful ideas. But what I took out of it is that all I need to do to make you feel calm is to breathe. And I tell you, that sets the bar pretty low, and I'm happy about that. We are so lucky to have the center, a place where we can continue to grow closer to who we were meant to be. And now it is your opportunity to help ensure it is here for your continued growth and to be here for the next person who comes to us looking for spiritual growth. We welcome your financial energy. And if you are willing, please repeat this affirmation after me. I know that my giving, blesses and multiplies, all that I am,
all that I have,
and all that I give and receive.
Together
we say, I do give eternal thanks for the abundance that is mine to share. And now once more, we have the light and the power and the energy and the fun of Tanya Lipscomb. Here's Tanya.
Kelowna Center for Spiritual Living. It's Tanya, and I want to remind you that all of you, you are a bright light of the brightest kind. You lift us up with your beautiful smile, with your warm heart and your quick mind. What an honor you're in our life. Well, there's joy in your gentle soul. You give and give, then wish you could give more. Your grace leads the way every moment of every day. In your darkest hour, you showed us courage and hope. In your darkest hour, you rose. No task too big, no mountain too high to climb. You keep inspiring day and night all the time. Through thick and thin, the veils, the winds, you take it all in stride. You're a bright light of the brightest kind. You're a bright light of the brightest kind. You know what? You bring me to my knees with your positivity. You bring around the bend when I'm at my wit's end. And your bright light of the brightest kind lights up my life. Woo! 'Cause you're a bright light of the brightest kind. You're a bright light. You're a bright light of the brightest kind. Of the brightest kind. Much love to all of you. I hope this wild outfit brightened up this dark and dreary January. I'm sending love to all of you and care and compassion. Stay safe and be well. Thank you so much for having me. Mwah.